Hey guys, so I just got done getting another thief for myself, and if you guys watched the Quirks tier list that I posted yesterday, thief is pretty much what is equivalent to Draconic, or would be if you are an anime fighters player. And in this video we're gonna talk about the importance of actually getting yourself some really good utility teams. Now, utility teams will help you to really just progress the game at an exceptional pace. Now, unfortunately, I actually cannot lead this guy to a tier 2 to continue with my roles. So, yeah, regardless, what I was talking about was the utilities. Now, we do have two mythical passives in the game, Leprechaun and Thief. So, Leprechaun is essentially luck 4. It also has a Nari Coins boost implemented to it. And we also have Thief, which is essentially Draconic, NKA, Collector 3. And this update right now, guys, is the best update to go for them. Now, Cosmics are still pretty hard to actually achieve, so I wouldn't really bother going for Cosmics if I was you. Also, update is coming, and you guys have probably realized, especially if you were a day one player, that the amount of rerolls that you could get in your hands, or medals rather, is extremely high. Now, how does that help you? You have a lot of rerolls to actually get those things. Now, let me just go ahead and unequip all of my units, right? You see, currently my luck is at 8x and my drops is at 2x. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna equip my luck team. And you know what, actually, to showcase this a little bit better, let's go to... That's not what I wanted to do. Now, let's teleport over to the hell. Okay, I just found the bug. GG. Alright, I guess the maps are back in place. Well, I am not back in place. What is going on? Oh my god. Gary, fix my character. Thank you. Okay, perfect. Well, we're back, but we're invisible. All right. Well, we just found three bugs in literally 1 second. Perfect. So anyway, as you can see, my current like rates look something like this. 8% for the legendary, 0.2% for the Goku. With 8x luck, that is obviously with all of the luck game passes. So if you don't have the same luck, it is because you don't have the game passes. But yeah, so plus 1 luck from lucky and plus 2 luck from super lucky. So yeah, normally my luck would be 5x. I do have the 25 hours, I think it was, the luck achievement, which you probably don't. But yeah, anyway, with 8x luck, these are my things. So I'm gonna go ahead now and I'm gonna start equipping all of my luck units, and we're gonna see how the rates will dramatically change. So, okay, that's my damage unit, CT, drops. Right, where's the luck? There we go, luck. And I have one empty slot, as you can see. I've only equipped 6 units because normally, like, you would probably want to equip your strongest unit, right? But let's just say that we equip this Leprechaun as well. Obviously, this is not a mythical, so you can only have one passive, one critical on it. And there you go, you see my luck is more than double. I actually have 17x luck right now. Look at this. Legendary bumped up to 17%, and the mythical is up to 0.42. Now, on the bright side, and the contrary to anime fighters, this game luck system is actually not problematic. If you have been watching me for a while, if you play in AFS, you might have heard that luck in anime fighters was completely a mess, and essentially at some point the more luck you had, your chances to get a divine were less. So in this game, that's not an issue. The more luck you can pump out, the better. So technically, with this team that we have right now, we can get up to 34x luck, which is completely ridiculous. And vice versa, 2x drops. I've got to equip my drop units. Now, my drop team is still under construction, so it's not pushed to its limits. We can definitely get a lot more drop rates. Well, we still have 6 actually, but yeah, I'm missing a collector 3, I believe. It's a collector 3. And that's missing collector 3. Collector 3 right here, collector 3. And yeah, like, trust me guys, this will make a dramatic difference, the amount of like medals you can farm from raids. So there you go, 8.70 luck. That is a lot of luck. Like, realistically, if we get a collector 3, it's gonna be 9, and with a boost it's gonna be 18. So yeah, invest some time in your utility teams. Like, it will help you a lot, especially like right now. Obviously, updates coming every week. Like, you don't really even shouldn't really bother going for Cosmics right now. That's my opinion. Just spend some time to get those utility teams. Obviously, level up your units just to be strong enough and you don't fall behind. But after that, just invest time in your utility teams. They will really make your life a lot easier. Like, it's literally doubling your amount of luck. Now, one very important thing, as you guys have noticed, I don't have a single team with double Leprechaun, right? You have not seen a double Leprechaun on my team, and that is due to the fact that you cannot get the same passive twice. Now, this is intended, 100% intended, and it is confirmed by Direp. I'll post the picture as well, as you can see, confirmed by Direp himself that you cannot roll duplicate perks. So, like, the game is really trying to incentivize you to have diversity in your passives. That goes the same for your like damage units. You can't go for double black hole units. And a lot of people have been asking, well, my obvious answer is get black hole first and whatever you get doesn't really matter. But I think Archmage is the way to go to, especially for like raids and pretty much any content that's challenging. If you just want to farm giant might be better, like if you just want to auto farm boss this. But yeah, in terms of like boss output, Archmage is the shit to go for. And yeah, that's it. So yeah, you want to go for Leprechaun and Lucky 3. Now, one thing, a big tip that I will give you, how to actually achieve these with the least amount of frills and the least amount of pain, is what you actually want to be doing is you want to come here and you want to get like an empty unit, right? Like this. So on the first quirk, what you want to turn on is you want to turn on, well, you know this, like that's just something different. So obviously you want to turn on Black Hole. If you get Black Hole, you are going to be playing this unit in your main team. And then you want to turn on Thief or Leprechaun. You don't want to bother with Lucky 3 or Collector 3. And you just want to keep rolling. And whatever you get from those mythical unit passives first is going to be whatever the unit will end up being, right? Now you see here, mythical passives, they have 0.2% chance. That is 1 in 500, just to do the math for you. So on average, you have to spin 500 times to get one of these mythical passives, as they're all 0.2. And yeah, that way you ensure that the mistake that a lot of people do doesn't happen. So let's say, for example, that I roll, right? I pop a Lucky 3. Lucky 3 is 1.3% chance to get. And then you roll here on your second quirk to get the Leprechaun, right? And then you end up getting a Thief. And you're kind of like tilting about getting Thief. So that's basically the way to prevent this from happening. And you get the least amount of failed rolls. Well, quote unquote failed. But yeah, you're wasting the least amount of time. So try to get the Leprechaun or a thing on the first slot. Now, you might ask me, Niels, what the fuck are you saying? Like, your Leprechaun is on second slot here. It's on second slot here as well. It's on the first slot here. Well, it's a lot. Yeah, see here, it's a Thief on the second slot. Well, we didn't know that yesterday that this was a thing, so obviously we just kept the Collector on the first. Also, the game just started, so obviously, you know, we're gonna keep the Collector on the first slot and then we're gonna roll. And good thing I actually saw that. I need to replace this with a Lucky 3, so that's exactly what I'm gonna do. And yeah, basically that is the way that you guys can spend the least amount of rolls. Just get a mythical on the first slot, whichever way it is, and then on the second slot you can go. Obviously, if you get something you don't need, like you chase after a Leprechaun, you get a Thief, just leave the unit in your inventory and continue on. Remember, you are gonna have plus one extra equip really, really soon, so just leave it in your inventory. It doesn't hurt me there, and carry on another unit. But yeah, can't stress the importance of this. Like, these things are gonna help your progress a lot, especially with the coming updates next week. Now, medal drops have been nerfed. The bosses have been capped for not every kill to give you medals, and the raids have had a sufficient nerf to the amount of things that you get from them. So yeah, make sure you just go ahead and get your utility teams before the next update, so you're all set and you are going to be doing very well pace wise on the next update. Just keep that in mind. And yep, that's pretty much it for this video. Just want to show you guys the difference of what a full team does to what having no physios does in comparison to your stats. And yeah, the difference is pretty big. It literally doubles your chances of getting a mythicals and cosmics, obviously, which is gonna be the end goal, moving onwards. But yeah, that was pretty much it for this video, guys. As always, if you have enjoyed, make sure to click the like and subscribe button down below, and I'll catch you guys all on the next one. Peace out.